I got my Kangol. Good morning. Hi, good morning. My name is Carlos. I am one of the volunteers here with Restoration Bridge Trinity Church. We have guests over here. We have the community. We are blessed to say that we are blessing the community as a blessing for ourselves, all right? We are also a blessing to a Good Shepherd Church. We want to thank them for the use of the property, for permitting us to do this. And also Good Shepherd is also providing breakfast for our guests and for our meals. And we want to thank you very much for your support, your loving kindness, and thank you for all your donations. We certainly appreciate it. My name is Carlos, Restoration Bridge. Have a nice day.
Heard a noise in the car.
Oh, we've worked here for 3 or 4 years, both of us. We've worked at the old place in here, and we love helping people. We're here every week, and it's just a great thing that we do. I think.
Yeah. I agree. Mm-hmm. And it's fun to help.
It's fun.
Great.
To make a difference.
Great. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay, and here we have various people that are helping to distribute the food. They're waiting for clients to come by, and they can choose what they'd like to take with them.
He was part of it.
Yes!
Karen, come on!
Come on, my friend.
Come on, Karen. Get a picture or a video or whatever.
Okay, tell us what happened.
Hi, Zombie.
Good to meet you.
Are you the pastor?
Are you the heaven-bound woman? You're one of my sisters. She's my sister now.
Thank you.
Yep.
Yay. I got found.
What's
I had
name?
Nobody. B-Hup.
What is it? I'm sorry?
B-Hup Beatrice.
Beatrice.
Yeah, they call me Miss B.
So tell me what happened. Tell us what happened.
So I came here because Miss Carol and Betsy told me to come here on Saturday for food. I had before 5 o'clock this morning. I felt rotten. I said, let me go there. But every time I drove by here, Father kept saying, "Get to my house." I'm like, yeah, I called Jesus. Why is my father? I came at this lady. I asked her for a glass of water. I said, can you give me something to eat? Because I'm nauseous, I take medication. And we started talking, and she goes, have you ever been reborn? I didn't know what she was talking about. But I told her that, I have so many sins that weigh me down. And she said, well, Father already paid them. I'm like, what are you talking about? She said, Father paid your sins. I'm like, what? What?
Yep.
It was like, everything came out of me.
Yeah.
I even thought, I'm praying, okay, I paid that one.
Yeah.
So most of the girls on the street know me because I help them.
Okay.
Like the young lady there, I go to the trail where they work. And I make sure they have food, make sure they have clothes. You know, they're on the street. Yeah. They're doing what they do for their addiction. I have no addictions. I don't drink. I don't smoke. I don't do drugs.
You're addicted to Jesus now.
Yes. I have found myself, back to home, in situations where I knew was wrong.
Yeah.
I've had guns pointed at me. I've had things taken from me. I've had decisions where you want this or you want that to be able to take off in my life. Mm-hmm. Here, I come here and I'm so alone. I find myself gravitating to situations I know are wrong. But I said at 5 o'clock this morning, I got to be there. Something calling me. And this woman just told me, come and say your sins. And the Spirit got in me. And she's like, do you feel it? I'm like, no. But then as I'm walking away, I'm like, why do I feel so different? It's like a whole ton got taken off of me.
We can bleep it.
Beep, beep, beep. Yeah. But it was like so much weight of, I have a problem. If you do me wrong, I hold a grudge.
Sure.
She tells me, give it to Father. He'll take it. Jesus will take all your pain, all your anger. So that's what I have to work on. Because when you're helping somebody on the street and you give them everything and then they take everything for yours, yeah, I'm a human. I'm going to be mad. I'm going to look you down and then I'm going to fight like I told you. All right, so I'm going to give it all to Jesus, okay? I'm not a liar. I'm not fake. I don't have time for that. I need this. I need the love that's real.
And we need you.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah. That's right. And you're going to go share the same thing that Narina did with you.
That's right.
Talk with a girl. Are you reborn?
Yes.
You're going to tell them your story, preferably one of them today. So
yeah.
Ask your father, the spirit he's put in you,
okay,
to lead you to somebody. Number. And then just keep the antennas up.
All right.
And see who it leads you to.
Okay.
I think she wants to be baptized.
We can arrange that.
Okay.
Well, we can arrange it right now if you want.
Want to get baptized?
Yeah, right
Come
now.
Come on, let's do it.
You can.
I'm down.
Cold. Okay. We got a towel. We got a robe.
I don't care what I do. Hallelujah. So Father's in me. Mm. That's the spirit.
His
right?
spirit is in you. His spirit. The spirit that was in Christ. The spirit of Christ. The Holy Spirit is in you. And he wants to guide you.
Right.
Speak to you. You learn how to sense his voice, his presence, his leading. He wants to transform you. He wants to do his work through you. And what's his work? Well, his work is love, service, sharing the good news, healing people, delivering them from spirits. That's his work.
Okay.
It's never changed since the beginning.
Well, I start he likes do that to do anyway,
every
day.
He likes to use everyday folks like us.
Right.
He gets a thrill out of it. Yeah.
So I'm like one of the soldiers.
Then the other person knows. Well, they end up you. That's got to be a God.
Right.
That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. See, they're going to see me and go, what's the matter with you? Something different
them.
About you.
You tell them what's the matter.
Yeah, then you tell them.
Look, God jumped in. Jesus is in me. Went to church for food and got Jesus.
You got spiritual food.
That's right.
You got spiritual food.
You got heavenly food.
I love you.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's go get.
It's like angel food cake. Yeah.
Angel.
No more devil's food. Yeah.
No. Nothing with the D word, doctor.
Yeah.
But I want to be here for Mass tomorrow.
Yes, and service.
And
we call it worship.
Worship?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're kind of a mess. Not a mess, but.
mass?
Yeah.
Now you sing? You sing?
Oh, they're singing.
Oh, yeah.
We
sing.
Yeah. Not that I can sing, I just don't hear
And
that.
I'm going to give
we
you
meet
a
the big
flag.
Building over there.
Wave it around.
Really?
The flag is like.
The flag's like praising God with a certain color, and the colors mean something. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're red for the fun.
Your sister now.
Yes, thank you.
Tell me your name again.
Bless
you. Tell me your B.
B E A.
Yeah.
Beatrice.
Beatrice.
Beatrice what?
Huff.
Huff.
Huff and Puff.
Now you won't forget it.
God bless
you. Yes, you did.
Yes, you did.
Amen,
oh boy!
I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Oh my God! I feel high right now.
Yeah, it's the Holy Spirit. That's all you'll ever have.
Yeah.
No kidding.
That's the Holy Spirit. And what you say is, as you walk around now,
and
you feel that, you say more.
Give me more, Father.
Give me more.
Yeah.
Fill me up more.
Okay. Remember, he's in you now.
You'll learn.
There's no limits to his spirit to fill you.
That's awesome.
To a point where you can heal and touch others and you can pray for others and you have the
Get some baptismal ready. All right.
But don't let that feeling go. Capture it. Hold
no,
on.
No, I'm feeling it.
And ask for more. Keep asking for more and he'll fill you and fill you and fill you. Every day, ask for more. More.
Thank you. You
know what
I'm
again?
Doug.
I have
a boyfriend.
We need to pray for
these
people.
I'm shaking her hand.
I know, I'm sorry. This lady needs housing. They need housing.
Oh my God. I feel so high right now. Is that crazy?
Oh, it's so cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
He will never leave you.
He will
never leave you.
He
will never leave you. As long as you
stay here.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know, Father, thank you.
Amen.
Yeah. Oh, he's
such a good God.
Wow. I was so alone. I can't believe this. Now
no more.
I feel like that.
And this is your brother, Mark.
Hey, Mark, I'm sorry. Mark, I didn't forget you. Oh, you feel so good. You're all good, aren't you? I felt that when I just hugged him. He's good. He's pure. Pure.
Yeah, he's cute. He's pure. Yeah.
I want to be like you, Mark.
And that, what you just did,
you just threw that.
You discerned. That was the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit in you, discerning the Holy Spirit in him. And that's what that is.
So our spirits just clang together.
Well, I sometimes, not all the time, but you know.
But I felt him.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus. He changes us.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what he does. He wants to make us like him.
Yeah.
We're called Christians because we're like Christ. So His Holy Spirit is in us, but it's up to us to be pure and holy. And I think the closer we get to the Lord, the more we feel it.
Yeah.
Some people are not, they're just kind of living half in the world and half trying to live half with the Lord. You're not going to have the presence of God like that.
Yeah, because you can't play it by yourself.
Right.
I was just going to ask you, I felt your pureness, one. Uh-huh. How do you do it in this world? How do you walk around and give off that?
It's just happened recently like that. I'm getting closer to the Lord recently. More and more, I mean, the most important thing in my life is to be in touch with Him. And you can't mess around with sin. You can't have that if you're playing, you know.
Right, that's right? A good way you put it.
Yes.
Right? You can't.
No.
But actually, you know, I'm not an expert on this, but I've heard things like in the spirit realm, they can see like there's an aura. You've heard about that?
Yeah.
Right?
Uh-huh.
And so, but it, for some it's brighter, for some it's just barely there. Right. So it's about us being in the presence of God.
Yes.
It's about us seeking Him, keeping our lives holy and pure. And then just living for Him, and that's when the Lord is there to do amazing things.
Wow.
Because like it says in the Bible, Stephen was full of faith in the Holy Spirit, and he did amazing, amazing things. God was able to use him as a vessel to do amazing things. And so, as we let our lives be a living sacrifice and live only for Him, then He's there to move through us. And just last night, I was in the Lord's presence, just something new for me last night, just spending time with Him, like a friend, like he said, Jesus said in Revelation that if we open the door, He and the Father will come and sup with us. And so just fellowship with us. And so that's what the Lord wants to do, is just be a friend. But He can't, if there's not holiness, then He can't be around like that. So we have to keep our lives set apart for Him and holy. And then He can do what He wants to do. We can enjoy that fellowship and communion with Him.
And still walk around all this. All these people that are not saved.
Right, and we can be the light.
Temptation.
Because yes. Jesus said we're the light of the world.
The light, yes.
And so we prayed for people. We've seen people get healed this morning. But this is even better.
Yeah.
This is even better.
It's like my mind is like, mm-hmm. I never drank in my life, but I feel like.
Praise God.
Yeah. I know it's Jesus.
Yeah. That's right.
Because yeah. I have nothing, Mark. I have nothing when I give me a that man. And I kept telling him, I said, drive him. He's like, B, come to my house.
This is what this is what we live for, to see this happen. Because it's a miracle, a changed life, right?
Yeah.
24 hours ago, how was your life compared? Just bad, huh?
Yeah. Bad, Mark, bad. I'm straight up, on everything that I love. I looked at a gun, okay? I lost my husband a year ago.
Yeah.
I've been with him 36 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I went to the doctor yesterday, and he goes, B, you're very depressed. I said, I know that. He goes, have you thought about being with Frank? And I knew, Mark, that if I answered the wrong way, I would walk out of that office.
Wow.
Because if I had told him, look, I wanted that gun to do what I was going to do.
Uh-huh.
And the only thing, Mark, that I thought of was, if I do this,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to leave a mess.
That's right.
And I thought, is that your way, Father?
That's not the solution, right? That's not what the Lord wants. Yeah.
He doesn't want me.
Like that.
And I want to be with my husband. He's like, it's not your turn.
That's right. You got work to do.
This lady's got a lot of work to do.
Yes, I do.
Yes.
And I will be so honest with you guys that it is what it is. I am. Everything that you people want to help, I'm standing in front of you. Because I'm street. You know what I'm saying? Prostitutes know me. They're junks know me. I've never done anything sexual. But I've been there for them. I parked the car and wait for them to do what they're going to do, jump in my van so they're not walking.
But you are not that anymore, Peter.
I know.
You are a daughter of the King now.
So I stay away right now?
Until you get stronger and you can begin to, and you really get hold of the Word, get into John like Norina told you to read, and you really understand the love of Jesus Christ. That way you'll be able to share that same love with those girls on the street.
Right.
You know? But you got to know it first. You got to know it. Okay? And all it'll do is confirm what's happened to you today.
Yeah.
The love that you feel right now and the peace that you feel right now, that's what you're going to...
Stay with me.
Yeah.
He said that. Doug said,
you
just
stay...
ask for more and more. Well, what I feel, like when I felt when I hugged Mark, There is something about the immortal.
Yeah, well, he explained it very well. Wow. That is, yeah.
It's Jesus. And that's what he wants to do. He wants to do the same thing in your life.
Yes.
That's what he wants to do with everybody.
That's right.
And that's what the gospel is. See, some people have a very weak gospel. Okay. They just want a ticket to heaven.
Yes.
But that's not what we want, right?
No. Yeah.
What we want is to live for him now and let his power be live through us, change us. Jesus came to save his people from what? From their sin.
Yeah.
He came to save us from sin. Right. So the problem in the world is sin. That's what's wrong with it, right?
Yes, it's, sir.
Okay? So that's why Jesus didn't come just to give us a ticket to heaven. He wants to purify us so that when we are ready to die, we're ready to be with him and we're already purified, because that's what his blood washes us.
Yes.
And then his spirit gives us the power to live the life that pleases him.
And it'll be a life of abundance.
It's
a life of abundance. Everything that is his is yours.
Everything that you said. And when she said Jesus, the spirit just got in me. I'm like, okay. Until we walked away. When I came over here, when I hugged this man, I felt, it was like, you know when you touch an electric?
Yeah,
uh-huh. You ever did that?
Yeah.
The rug and you, that's what I felt off of him.
Yeah.
But it was all good.
Yeah.
I said, I do have. And then I'm like, hi. I'm like, so that's Father.
Yeah, it's Holy Spirit. Yeah, that
you're sensing. That's what he wants to do with every member of his body.
Yeah.
That's what he wants to do.
That's right.
So you're going to be part of that solution.
That's right.
Wow, that's awesome.
That's it. Yeah. You're part of the work. You like it?
I would love that.
You got it. You got the commission right now.
That's right.
Thank you.
All right, now we're going to get you baptized very shortly.
Right now.
Yeah, we're getting ready now.
Yeah, I'm ready. And it's real. It's from my heart. That's what's awesome. You know
yes, what I mean? It's very real.
Nothing could be more real than this right now. Wow. Look at the clouds. They're so fluffy. They know I'm going to be clean.
You are already.
I'm going to be like one of them
clouds.
Yes.
Fluffy and clean.
That's it. Whiter
than
snow.
That's right.
Give me whiter than snow. That's what Jesus does.
That's right.
Wow. You better hold my hand because...
I will be right here with you, sister.
Oh, my goodness.
What? In the Catholic Church, they canonize saints. But we don't do that. Because God don't do that.
That's right.
Well, you got all the saints you pray to? No. But you know, in the Catholic Church, St. Joseph prayed. But now, in the Bible, you'll read, when he talks about the saints, you're a saint now. You've got the Holy Spirit living in you. You got to be a saint.
I am so high right now.
We're all considered saints now. So you can put on your saint outfit.
Yeah. Are we gonna take her to the big house?
We're gonna now over here.
Oh, here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's go. Let's go.
Are you kidding me?
Come on, Pastor. Don't forget, I got.
Oh no, you don't want the Bible.
Instead of letting bees will be done, it's letting his will be done to the best that you can. It's like a surrendering. It's like a dying to yourself. At baptism, it's an immersion. What happens to the body if you kept it underwater? It dies.
It kaputs.
Flip in. It'll come up.
Yeah.
And,
it's all right.
I can't take it.
No, it's good.
Yeah, it's real.
But it's a death. Yeah. And then it's a taking on of a new life. So when you take in air, it's as if you're taking in the Holy Spirit. So, you know, when you go under, you're saying goodbye to the old me and your will. And you're going to be considering his will to be done with everything in life. Okay, God, you know, what do you want to do with me today? And what's your desires for my life today? So it's allowing his spirit to live through you. You've already experienced the Holy Spirit out there. That's cool. Some experience it when they come up out of the water. You know? And so we're just going to, when you come out of the water, we're just going to be praising God, and you can be praising him too. Just thank him. Just let your mouth thank him. Let it come out of your mouth.
I can't. I mean, the feeling right now, and I'm going to tell you straight up, I am high, and I don't do drugs. But when she said the spirit got in me, I'm like, okay, you know. So we walked away because we were going to meet Father. All of a sudden, I'm like, why do I feel like so lightheaded and drowsy? Like, it's because the feeling that she told me I had expected right now, yesterday, right? It didn't happen. It happened when he chose to give it to me. And it was when I was walking in the chair and you was coming towards me.
Yeah.
I felt that it's still in me.
Yeah, oh yeah. He won't leave you.
And my eyes dilated. I'm telling you, I'm so messed up right now. And it's got to be him. There's no other thing. Yeah. I had nothing. Zero. I have no people out here.
Well, we're going to have a prayer over you when you come out of the water.
Okay.
Because the enemy doesn't like what you've just done. He didn't want you to know about the Holy Spirit. He didn't want the Holy Spirit to live in you and through you. The Holy Spirit's sovereign over the enemy, that is all other spirits. And so they'll put all kinds of deceptions and lies back into you, making you doubt what you've experienced.
I felt it.
Well, I know.
You can't tell me wrong.
Excellent. But, you know, we're learning how to war with the lies and deceptions of the enemy.
Yeah.
And how to keep our faith in the Holy Spirit, but we do it together. See, something happened when you're with others because God likes to do things through people.
Right.
He's creating a family. He's got a bunch of sons and daughters. You got brothers and sisters.
Yeah. Thank you, baby, because I was alone. Now I'm not.
You see this family?
Thank you.
Ladies, are you got any questions?
No, I'm ready.
Let's get done with B here.
You know what? Let's go. You stand in here first. Yeah. Because just to get your body kind of warmed up to it. Burn.
Whoa, Dad. This is cold.
No, yes, it is cold.
You got towels?
Yeah.
Oh, Daddy.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sorry we didn't have a warmer in this
That's
one.
That's okay. Yeah. It goes with everything.
Yeah. Take your time. Just wait. Just when you're ready.
Take care.
Well, you let him know when
back?
You're ready.
You're going back? She's going forward.
Okay. Yeah. You'll go.
I want to thank you, everybody. Bring me into your family. Guys, I'm ready.
His
you
family.
Just adopted a little devil. But
No more. Now you're saved.
I am ready.
Yeah. Okay. I was baptized in the name of Jesus.
All right. Yes. Yeah. Go ahead and baptize you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
Father. Thank you, Father. We're going to pray right now. Thank you, Father, for the Spirit of God that is in this woman, Father God. Thank you that today is her new life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Praise your holy name. Thank you, Father, that she's a new creation. All is forgiven. And she stands white as snow before you, Father God.
Old cleanse.
She is a new creation. Praise your holy name. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
You have an inheritance.
My physical body right now, I'm going to tell you what I'm going through. It's racing. And it's like my hands like, I'm jumping out of my body. Is that the best? Me going to sleep. He's leaving me, right?
Yes,
he must be.
Thank you, Father. Thank
you, so much. Oh my goodness.
And I'm here for you. Anything you will have done this?
Yep. Yes.
So each one knows.
Yes. Yep. Oh, yes.
Absolutely.
My body. Okay.
Except we put ice in the water for you.
I like him. All right. I'm going to be good. And thank you all.
Amen.
Because I was nothing.
Well, this is just the beginning. This is
more.
Oh, yeah.
Father's
this is like a birth. So you know, we don't want you to stay on the baby bottle.
Yeah. I am so sorry.
Exactly. Hell no. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to be
real. Just be real.
I am. I'm sorry. I'm with you.